Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, we'll clearly understand how exactly to perform dilation and erosion. Mathematically, I'll prove you that. This is a little longer time that we need with respect to this session, but that is certainly useful. I'm going to first explain you what is dilation. I'll explain you what is erosion. Then we'll take an instance. We'll go ahead mathematically to prove it. It will be very easy for you. What is dilation? Dilation is simply a process of adding something more to whatever is existing. I have got an object, I'll add something more to it. The something is nothing but a layer of pixels, that's all. Dilation is addition. Dilation is inclusion, that's all. This is what colloquially I can tell you. But technically speaking, this is the process through which the probing and expanding the shapes inside the image happen. So please understand, I'm going to clearly add some content to the picture, content to the object to make sure that I can identify the shapes in easier way. So this can be connected to the local maximum filter. You must have studied that somewhere else in the past and you need to just connect it to it. Just like local maximum filter. We really add a very simple layer of pixels on the object boundaries and dilation will increase the number of pixels over there and the object. Okay. The morphological dilation is fundamentally meant to get the objects more visible and it would fill even the smallest holes in the object. So what do you mean by that, sir? The dilation would improve the visibility. I have an object in an image and that image, that object should be clearly presented. That should be made more visible. So what technique would I go for? I will go in for dilation and certainly it will help me with that. Now what is erosion? As you know, it is definitely opposite to dilation. Erosion will remove the pixels on the object boundaries. It is again like the local minimum filter. You could see it here. Here it was a local maximum filter and here it is local minimum filter. That's it. So we are going to remove the pixels on the object boundaries and we are going to remove that layer of pixels in the object boundaries through the erosion process. Erosion will reduce. Dilation will increase. That's it. So morphological erosion will remove the island and small objects so that only substantive objects remain. This is a process through which we are removing the islands and small objects. That's all. This is called erosion. Now, can we understand it a little better? Dilation is about increasing the size, but erosion is about decreasing the size. Dilation fills the holes and disconnected areas, whereas erosion removes the smallest of the anomalies in the image. Dilation is nothing but an XR operation with A and B, but erosion is a dual of dilation. That's all. This is the fundamental difference that I can give you. Now, this is the input image. Once dilated, you could see that it has got thickened. And once eroded, it has got thinned. So dilation is all about thickening process. Erosion is all about thinning process. That's all. It's very, very simple, right? This example is sufficient for you. Now, let's go ahead with math. We need to go ahead with math. But before that, there is something that you need to remember and understand. There is a term called structural element. What is this, sir? This is new inclusion. Now, this has been used earlier, but we used a different term in the past and we used it as the kernel or the filter. So we are going to use the same thing here. We will have a matrix, a small matrix that represents a shape and the content of the matrix could be 0 or 1 and whatever content you fill in generally represents the shape of the structural element. And I am going to use this structural element alongside the input image. I will act with the structural element over the input image and I will do the erosion and the dilation operation. Can you go ahead with it? I am going to start with erosion first. And then I'll go ahead with dilation and the structural element is taken as 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. And this is arbitrary and I have taken it as my choice. Now here I've got an input image and you could see that it is a 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Likewise, I have filled it and I'm going to now operate this on this. All right. This is something that we need to understand very clearly right now. So what are we going to do is we are going to identify the center element of the process. I mean of the structural element first. That's the first step. Now once it is identified, now you see that what is the center element of the structural element? This is the center element. Now you need to pick it. You are going to hand pick it exactly and I'm going to move it here. Now let me go back here so that I can explain you this better. Now I am marking the center element. I need to pick it. I am hand picking it exactly. I am moving this structural element here and that should be matched with this place. So you are going to keep this in such a way that this center element is exactly getting mapped to this place. So what will happen? Your center element, when is moved here, it will look something like this. See that. So the center element is 1, and you can see that there is an element to the left, there is an element to the right, there is an element to the top and bottom. So I need to make sure that I keep things proper here. If I miss it, I may not be able to get the computation proper. Now what I do, I need to keep it, I need to hover it over it, and I could see that 0, 1, 0 goes above, because this is the central element. Now you can refer this 0, 1, 0, and this is the central element in such a way that this will become 1. This is the central element for me. And what is the element to the right for the central element? The right element is 1, the left element is 1. There is no left pixel, so it can be ignored. There is no top pixel, it can be ignored. There is bottom pixel, but it is 1, so I have filled it. Now see rest of the pixels also, and you can go ahead. Now what is the pattern that we need to understand? Very simple. The idea is very, very easy here when it comes to erosion. When I keep it, when I keep this image, when I move this structural element to the main image, I mean this center, this part of it, we have taken this part and we have processed it, right? If wherever I have ones, the ones are all should be fitting exactly over with the ones in the input image. What do I mean, sir? Very simple. You can see that here, all the ones here, whatever I have in the image, should be matching with the structural element. The structural element has got center part 1, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here. But here, if you see in this section, I have got 1 matched with 0. Let me clear it so that it will be easy for you. I have got 1 here in the structural element, but in the matrix, it is 0. Input image, it is 0. I have got 1 here, it is 0 here. I have got 1 here, it is 0 here. I've got 0 here, it is 1 here, it doesn't matter. So the point is, wherever I have 1 here, this structural element, wherever I have 1 here, that should all be mapped exactly. It should be like 1 on 1, 1 on 1, I mean it. In that case, I can mark that pixel as 1. If there is no match when I keep the central element over here, when I match the central element over here, then it should be marked as 0. You can see that explicitly it is clearly visible, since there is a 0 here, right away this is doomed. So I'll put a 0 here. There is a 0 here when I move the central element here, not matched. Likewise, I can keep moving and I can understand. But now when I come here, when I keep my central element here, this one when I keep here, you can see that this is matched, this is matched, this is matched, this is matched. So all the four elements surrounding it are also getting matched properly as per requirement. And hence, this pixel alone will get 1. That's all. So rest all pixels, if you see, when I keep it here, the right hand side is doomed. When I keep it here, the left hand side is okay, but the right hand side is nothing, the top is gone. So when I keep it here, the left is okay, but the top is gone. So likewise, I need to see the central element plus all these four directions. And if they all match to the requirement, I will keep it as 1. Only one part, only one cell gets this condition met, and there is where I made it as 1. So what is the final output, sir? Very simple. The final output of this input image acting with the structural element which I have taken is giving me this output. So essentially, what we do is the number of ones are reduced in the erosion process, and this is what I told you. Dilation is a process of thickening, whereas erosion is a process of thinning, and it will reduce the pixels. It will reduce the number of ones in the matrix. That's it. Now what do we do? It's time for us to understand dilation. I explained you the erosion process very clearly, I believe. If you have any questions, you can ask me that in the chat box. I'll be able to answer that. But let's take the same image. So I'm going to take the same input image, same structuring element, and we are going to process it. So what do I do? I'll start with this position, and this is the center for the structural element. When I keep it over here, the rule changes slightly. Last time I said, this is the central element. I have four neighbors to it. All the neighbors should be 1, and in that case only, including central element, in that case only I will put 1 here for erosion. But now what I say is, if any one of these are ones, that can still get 1 for you in the output. If any one of these, just take any one, that's fine. If any one of these is 1, you will get a 1 in the output. So now let's understand that. Now, which is the section that we are going to go ahead with? We are going to go ahead with this section, and now you can see that here it is all zeros, so I cannot do much. The output is zero. Now let's come to this section in the input matrix, and it will be like this when I keep it exactly over it. And you can see that here, as per my requirement, there is one available, so it meets the condition, hence it is one. Now let's go to this, where if you see, this would be the exact scenario that we are looking at when we keep the filter over it. And here I have one, so it doesn't matter. I'll put a one irrespective of rest of the values. Now I go to the next one, where you could see that I am exactly drawing that section, and you could see that there is one here, hence this also gets one. Likewise, I'll keep moving, and wherever there is a one, wherever you could see that all those will get ones for sure, because it meets the condition. At least one will have one. I mean, one cell will have one, and that meets the condition. So what I put, wherever there is one, I'll put ones at all those places, and I can go ahead with the rest of the processing. This is the easiest way you can cut short the lengthy process that you are doing. Now, where do I go? I need to go with the rest of the process, and that's what I'm going to handle right now. Now, we are going to see the sections which are left without processing. So we have completed this, we have completed this, and we have put ones in all the places. This one is to be seen right now. So in the input image, when I keep it here, that will also be one, because obviously we have one available and we have done it. So up to this is all done. So you can see that here, up to this is all done. I have one here, so I have no problem. It's all done up to this. Now what do we do? Now this is the section that we need to go on further. This is all already selected. Now we will go on with this. So let me go this way. This is easier. I have taken a fresh picture. So this is now to be highlighted. And see, so this is the central element. I have a neighbor, so this is safe. One. Similarly, I will go and highlight this. There is a one, and this is the central element. So this is to be given as one. I'll keep on going like this, and let's go to the right corner now. You can see that here. Do we have an element here as one? Yes, one is there. So this would be fine, and I have put a one. Similarly, I will come here. I will highlight. I have a one here. So this will be one. This is easy, isn't it? Dilation is easy. Erosion is further simpler. So now, this one is one, so I got one. Finally, I come here, and I'll have to put this. Now see that there is one, and hence this will also be one. So what do we do? Very simple. We have increased literally the number of ones from the input image, whatever we had earlier, and that's the process of dilation. You increase the number of ones, which means you are increasing the number of pixels as an additional layer over and above the existing object, and you are increasing it by size. That's it. So dilation is the process of addition, whereas erosion is the process of removal. That's how I can say it simply, and I have given you a very simple example, I believe. If you have any questions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer you. I hope you like the session. If you like the content and the session, please subscribe and give a thumbs up. Thank you very much.